Hello, I'm the Budget Mudder and welcome to episode 2 of my Eagle Transporter build. So, let's get down to business. I'm just going to take the parts off the sprue and do section A, but I'm going to build it with a bit of a twist. As you can see from these plans of the 22 inch Eagle, there are greeblies on the inside of these modules, so I've decided to strip it out and build those. Oh, you fool. I'll be cutting all the thick plastic out from in between these beams, but first things first, I have to mark out where I'm getting rid of the plastic. That's a good start. It's a wee pen. Whee! Let's find a better one and get on with marking out. That's better. Right, all marked up. Now to decide what tool I'm going to use with my rotary tool to rip all this thick plastic out. I ended up choosing a round-headed drill bit and a thin diamond grinder. I started out using the round-headed drill bit, drilling straight into the areas. I was going to follow that up using a thin diamond grinder to come in after that and grind the rest of the thick plastic away. But, as you can see, the round-headed drill bit got clogged up very quickly. Having swapped to the diamond grinder, I thought I'd give this a go. But that too got clogged up. After the third time of cleaning the diamond grinder, I decided to try and use something different. I might try a low grit sander, a grinding stone. So let's have a crack. That didn't help. The grinding stone hardly touched the plastic. It more melted it than ground it down. Here, I'm just checking which bits of the top of the module I need to remove. And looking at this picture, I may as well just remove the whole lot. Here, I'm just checking where the bracing that holds the container connects to the rear module, so I know where I need to cut it. And now I can mark it up. For some reason, I decided to glue the rear module together. Don't ask me why, but I did. I think I was getting a little frustrated with trying to get rid of all that thick plastic, but I glued it together. So, with the rear module put to one side, I decided I'd crack on and glue the engine parts together. This is another part of the kit I'm going to be doing some scratch building on. That's glued. Now for the container itself. The fit of this is not very good at all, but nothing a bit of fine fettling and some filler can't solve. Pop that over there, and I can now crack on with the landing gear section. I think this is what I wanted to do, get everything sorted and out of the way before I crack on with the modules, but let's see. I decided not to show the middle two as they went together just like the first one and the last one. I'll leave those to dry over there, and now we can finish off the container, hopefully. You can see the doors there where the base plate has opened them up. I feel a job for sprue glue there. It's a tad wide for filler. So, there's the container pod wrapped up like a Christmas prezzy. Now, to carry on with grinding all those thick plastic bits away, I'm still using a round-headed drill, but this time I'm attacking the thick plastic from behind. For now. Once I thought I had gone through the thick plastic enough, I tried the microsaw. As you can see, I'm not progressing very quickly. I've only got one part done. I need to find something a little quicker. I don't think you really want to watch everything that happens, just the important stuff. It took me an hour to get to this stage. At this rate, I'm going to be working on this till Christmas. All told, this half took me over 3 hours to do it. 3 hours! That's nearly 12 hours work for both modules. Cripes. I wonder if there's any quicker way to do it. Otherwise, I'm going to be a busy bunny. Look, I'm doing a show and tell. It still needs a bit of a clean up, I know, but the difference is going to be fantastic. So, I've been through my Greebly box, hunting for different things to use, and I'm just making some workings out here. So, let's crack on. ¶¶ there's my calculations done. So, now to start cutting some styrene into shapes that we can use. So, let's use the speedy uppy thing and get through it. Here, I'm just test fitting the sections into the module, just to see how they fit. That seems okay, so let's move on. Here, I'm now cutting out the supports for the box structure that will go inside the module. Now all the parts are cut, we can start to construct our structure to go in the module, using a speedy uppy thing. Okay, I lied. We hadn't finished cutting for this structure, but we have now. Honest.
Thank you.
Right, there it is built. Now let's see if it fits. Did anyone notice my deliberate mistake there? Congratulations if you did, and yes, I tested it in the wrong way. Oops. But it does fit the right way, honest, as you will see in a later video. So that's where we are with this build. And remember, if you like what you see, please subscribe to my channel, help it grow, get the message out there to as many modelers as possible, like the video and ring my bell. Remember, stay safe, keep on modelling.